We're back and continuing our playthrough of the old Magic the Gathering game that's been around for a very long time at this point. Imrakul drifts into Thraben, or Thraben. Her passage through Innistrad, leaving life warped and mutated in her wake. Thousands of warped cultists and mutated creatures follow her into the city, drawn like moths to flame. Between these transformed horrors and the Titans stand the Gatewatch, who arrived at Thraben or Thraben's entrance. I'm gonna go with Thraben. I feel better about that. Oh my gosh, this guy literally just standing up right next to a statue like, "What's up, bitches?" That's it for my turn. So this is a swamp deck, which is usually like a graveyard playing deck. So I just need to see card effects that make me pull things out of the graveyard. Oh, I knew it was a good thing to start with those four cards. Or those three. Also, it looks like I got something, so that's cool. And I can still play murder if I have to. Name of this card? Of the Horrid Swarm. No, it. That's what a fucking I and a T look like in Magic the Gathering? The fuck out of here. to transform into. Better be running out of fucking cards. Jeez. I did 3 mulligans and I'm still drawing crap. like if the zombie apocalypse shows up to the doorstep and then just goes like, "What's up, man? No, you want us to put our heads forward so you can put spikes in? Fine, alright." That's more or less what happened. I'm like, what kind of fucking cards were those? No lands. I even had two cards that kind of helped me with the lands. And I'm like, guess I'm not getting any lands. And I think the only real mistake I did, outside of attacking with one creature, was whenever I got the choice to use that one card to pull another card, this guy? No, someone else. The Midnight Scavengers. I should have pulled this guy instead of the Graph Rat, so I should have been focusing on building myself up still. Anyway, starting with three lands is okay. Get woken up by mom barking. It's not how I wanted to block, but I don't know the way to I know that if you're gonna lose cards, blocking with one card, and you try to use two, it's always gonna put the weak guy that's gonna die first. I'm like, okay. Thank you. want to see what the other side is. I want to see what the other side is. Supposed to even begin to outnumber this enemy or take advantage of the graveyard, because this deck clearly does not openly try to take advantage of its graveyard. Seen this character before. Okay, that's the first thing I've really done in like 3 freaking tries. Can't wait for the enemy to be at 37 health again. Wow, already. That's not a good time to play that card. What was that? Why did it tap? I felt like I was going somewhere and then I whiffed. And I keep whiffing when it comes to the cards that have multiple possible effects. So I'm like, I activate. Oh, I didn't activate. Oh. card spell was. I didn't have any fire cards. With a growing sense of horror, the planeswalkers realize force alone is unable to match the hordes of transformed villagers. Jace's ability to shield the minds of others from encroaching madness is starting to falter, so the gate watches overrun. And still, they haven't located Imrakul himself. Herself. All seems lost. With a zombie about to chomp his neck. Everyone else looks relatively okay. Got a claw hanging on to what's her face there, and that's about it. Chandra, that's right. I still haven't really played extensively as the guy on the left or the head of the gallery. Desperate for assistance, the Gatewatch attempt to contact Odric, the head of the town's council, but the townspeople have devolved into a frenzied mob. Many have unexpectedly transformed into Eldrazi monsters. Odric tries to leave, but the lines between friend and foe have blurred. There. The L ended up in foe and just disappeared from blur entirely. Amidst the chaos of battle, help arrives, bathed in violet light, leading an oncoming tide of undead. The Necromancer Liliana Vess. Yeah. That's a terrible start. That's not a good start either. I'll take that ratio. Play this? There are four or more card types among cards in your graveyard. Types. Okay. Some spells are the truth one. Oh, I can't do anything else. guess I also can't attack? What kind of bullshit is this? I wish there was a can't attack fucking button on there. The block is my fault, I didn't see the can't block button. Genius. I want to destroy an enchantment. Should have stuck with that first hand that I accidentally hit X on. I was like, it summons a planeswalker. I could probably use whatever planeswalker's in my inventory. Thank you. something with her from the graveyard? What can I do with you? yourself fighting back to back with an unlikely needed ally, the Eldrazi are driven back. Fighting their way outside the city, the Gatewatch finally reaches Imrakul. The Eldrazi Titan looms over them, gibbering masses of Eldrazi hordes clustered beneath their Liliana and Jace lead the Necromancer's undead army in a frontal assault, while the other Planeswalkers prepare their own powerful spells. So it's gonna be water and swamp, I guess? He's counterspelling in the fucking picture. Either he's counterspelling a fucking beam coming from the Titan's eye towards Liliana, or that's just Liliana. Which is a lot less cool. Yeah. If it's on the floor, it gets washed. Oh wow, I started off with him, that's cool. She's supplying more of the creatures and he's supplying the capsules. That's what it feels like here. Summoning a creature. That's just I'll wait until he's got the chittering bullshit out before I summon this creature. No, I'll let him throw himself at it and just sacrifice himself. Thank you.
Bella like that.
Magic door, I think.
Nah, I'm just playing for achievements. Like I do every game.
You like
I barely know how much to get them.
Yeah, I was wondering, did you buy that game? Is that a free game?
It was
or is
free.
That in my library?
Nah, it was free. Way back in the day.
The Witcher
went our game.
I think I own it. I didn't really get into it, I just downloaded it. Fun game. Fun game
for The Witcher. It's just like when you play The Witcher, the like one is fun. The game was kind of fun. I didn't feel like
I'm not worried about it, bro.
Yeah. Enjoy yourself.
Okay, don't enjoy yourself now, for fuck's sake. It's just a mountain. You don't make fucking disgusting bagging noises in your life. Exactly. I guess it's unavoidable to fucking wise guy. Angel hair with bummer is just a motherfucker. I don't know what it is, but just a dash of bummer is in the way. That greasy fingers slurping up the fucking angle of the pasta.
Metroid will be bound. Tamiyo and Misa combine their powers using Mistra's mystical silver bullet to find the Keeper Pool of Wisdom. Misa inscribes her bullet onto the lunar surface while Tamiyo's potent binding magic pulls the Titan into the imprinted.
Yes, he's just...
With the binding of Immercool, the remaining Eldrazi core is scattered, exhausted by the toll of the chain. Liliana finally allows herself to release her undead army to the slumber of the dead. She has seen the power of the Planeswalkers, which has the power strong enough to free her from the chain
monsters.
She gives her oath to the Game Watch, and now five Planeswalkers stand together to protect the multiverse.
Is that game like an RPG?
It's got a story, that's really it. You play with a deck that kind of fits the archetypes of the characters you're playing as, and then... Oh, I'm about to play like a werewolf guy or something. Alright. Among Innistrad's Dark Mountains, Jace Bellerin begins his search in the one place on the plane that he knows, the home of his ally Liliana Vess. But his path is fraught with danger, and Jace soon finds a cold welcome at the hands of a pack of werewolves.
Yeah, Jace is a blue deck, right? Jace is blue. It's like water.
Yeah.
I used to play that kind of shit, man. It's so expensive.
Phantasmal Bear. Okay.
Yes! Oh, that was almost... Oh, that was almost perfect, Wolfie.
That was almost fucking perfect, bro.
Holy shit. You blocked, like... Everything. Hold on, that was fucking beautiful. I swear to God, that was it, man. That was it, and he does one stupid move. Ugh, that stinks. Maron. Alright, so this is the one for you. This is pure hatred in an ambulance.
Thank you.
Benghazi, Benghazi, Benghazi. You would laugh if you know what I was listening to right now. Like, you know.
But we don't want no fucking laughs. It's not a night of laughs, it's a night.
You should, call it quits.
Yeah, you got 5 minutes.
Thank you. thought he was gonna say die, because he says he wants to die in the song.
At the end of this song, he's like, I'll curl up in a big ball and die.
Yeah, your health bar isn't... Einstein. It's 1 o'clock. I think this should be your last one because I'm peacing out after this. It's a sign that you're tired.
weren't on very long today. finish this up and then I'll eat some food. I would have been so mad if it just like froze right there, like, game crash. Yeah, back to yourself. Jason implores the villain to help him unravel the mystery. She rebuffs him, far more concerned with her own pursuits of the demons that still held power over her and of the chain men. She wants him to soar into some macabre, but she offers none. Alright, we will continue here shortly after I finish eating. Yeah, I'll just leave the stream.